Good morning, boys and girls. Welcome to the kindergarten Sabbath school class. I'm so excited you've joined us today. Our lesson is called Lot Chooses First. Sometimes we make choices without knowing everything we need to know. Our story today is about people making choices. Our memory verse is taken from Genesis 13, verse 8, which says, "Let's not have any quarreling between you and me." And the message for the story is, God's people put others first. Let's pray together. Dear Jesus, thank you for loving us. Help us to learn to put others first. We love you. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, boys and girls, let's sing. Oh, be careful, little eyes, what you see.
Oh, be careful, little eyes, what you see. Oh, be careful, little eyes, what you see. For the Father up above is looking down in love. So be careful, little eyes, what you see. Oh, be careful, little ears, what you hear.
Our story today is about community. In Christian communities, there are problems and challenges to face, but this story helps us know that we can settle problems fairly without quarreling. We're going to listen to the story of Lot Chooses First. And remember, boys and girls, pay special attention so that you can answer the questions after the story.
Lot Chooses First. When you play with others, do you share? Do you let them have the first choice? Abram did. He let Lot choose first. Abram heard loud, angry words in the distance. He looked at his wife Sarai. "It must be the shepherds," he said sadly. "They're quarreling again." Abram stepped out into the bright sunshine. "Master Abram! Master Abram!" Several shepherds shouted as they ran to him. "What's the matter now?" Abram asked. "Oh, master, we started to move your flocks of sheep this morning, but the servants of your nephew Lot followed us everywhere. Every time we found a good place where the sheep could graze, they threw rocks and sticks at us and at the sheep." Abram closed his eyes. He wished the problem would go away, but he knew it wouldn't. He and Lot were both very rich men, with large flocks of sheep and goats. Their servants had been arguing over grassy pastures and watering holes for a long time, and it was time for the arguing to stop. "I'll take care of it," Abram said to his servants. Soon he was standing in front of Lot's tent. "Uncle," exclaimed Lot when he saw Abram. How nice to see you! What brings you to my tent in the middle of the day?
Come walk with me, Abram responded. I want to show you something.
The two men climbed a small hill. From there they could see the whole valley spread out before them.
Lot, our servants are fighting over pastures and water, said Abram. The land here can't support both of our flocks. Let's not have any quarreling between you and me. It is time for us to separate.
Lot nodded. He knew his uncle was right. Abram looked across the countryside God had promised him.
You choose where you want to live. If you go to the left, I'll go to the right. If you go to the right, I'll go to the left.
Lot looked across the land. On the left, he saw good pastures. It would be a nice place to live. But on the right, the pastures offered better grass and the river would supply plenty of water. It would be a great place to live.
I'll go to the right, said Lot. Agreed, said Abram. I'll go to the left.
Abram walked Lot back to his tent and then continued on home.
Sarai, he called to his wife, we need to pack. The quarreling among the shepherds will soon be over. We're moving.
What an awesome story. God blesses Abram and Lot in Canaan, and they became wealthy people. But their servants quarreled over grazing land. So Abram and Lot agreed to resolve the quarrel by moving to separate places. They solved the problem without fighting. It's time for our questions. Our first question is, why did the servants of Abram and Lot quarrel? The correct answer is, they quarreled over the land for their animals to graze. Good job, boys and girls. Our second question is, what did Abram and Lot do about the quarreling? Abram and Lot decided to move to separate places. It's time for prayer. Let us sing the Lord's Prayer together. Thank you for joining us today, boys and girls. Remember, God's people put others first. Happy Sabbath and God bless you.